Hi, Steve.
Hi, Emily. Yeah, thanks for having me on your show.
Thank you for being here. I really appreciate you doing this and taking some time out of your busy schedule to do this.
It's great to speak to you.
It's great to speak to you too. How have you been?
Yeah, I've been really good, thanks. Yeah, trying to keep busy with the band and doing other bits and pieces while we're still in lockdown.
Oh, that's good. Okay, I have a few questions for you. This is a two-part question, really. Whose idea was it to start the band, and how did you all meet each other?
Yeah, so Last Misfit Heroes, we formed this time last year, roughly. It was probably April 2019. The band is made up of myself, Steve Catt. I play lead guitar and I'm also the singer. On the bass is Ange Jackman, and then on the drums is my cousin Chris. And yeah, we came together. I was looking to put a new project together. I had all these songs and ideas, and I was actually playing in a band with Ange at the time. So we had a conversation, and that was an obvious choice, really. We've known each other since school, so we've grown up together. We've got very similar tastes in music. We work really well together. You know, he's really laid back bloke, very easy to work with. And then following on from that, I spoke to my cousin Chris, who I knew played drums, and I'd sort of played in bands with him. Nothing serious, just sort of mess around. And I sort of said to him, you know, would you be interested in getting involved? And he was. And the three of us then got together, and it's gone from there, really. It's a very easy band to play in and work in, really. So, yeah, really happy. So, yeah, the idea of us coming together, that would have been really down to me. I was sort of looking for a new project. I was getting a bit frustrated with what I was doing in previous bands, and I wanted to sort of go back to what I enjoyed doing, really. And that was writing, performing, and just being able to enjoy the music. And I think what happens is sometimes in bands, you get bogged down with the, I wouldn't say politics of the band, but you get bogged down with other things in life that are going on, and you sort of lose the whole reason why you're in the band and what you're trying to achieve with the band. And really, with the Last Misfit Heroes, the idea with this band is just to be creative, really. Like we all, you know, sort of get involved in the whole process, and we're all part of the band, and we're just doing it because we enjoy it, really. And that's the main thing, and I think that comes across, especially with the material. If you come and see us live, there's definitely that feel to it that's going on.
Okay, for the next question, why did you want to be in a rock band rather than an indie or punk or other kind of band, other genre of band, I should say?
That's a good question, actually, because although we do play a lot of sort of rocky, I'd say we definitely take influences from other genres. I mean, me and Ange grew up on heavy metal, really. If you look at what we listened to when we were younger, we were definitely of the sort of I was big into the sort of classic British rock bands like Black Sabbath, Deep Purple, Zeppelin, those sort of bands. Me and Ange were both into Iron Maiden, then your Metallica's, Megadeth's, those sort of bands. And I think basically we played in those sort of bands, got that out of our system, and then we've taken on lots of other different influences over the years. With this band, I would say I definitely take influence when it comes to my guitar sound and my guitar playing to a lot of sort of punk rock type bands. I like very basic stuff which is powerful, and even sort of grunge as well. There's a lot of grunge bands out there the older grunge bands that I really like. Nirvana is a massive influence on this band. Alice in Chains, bands like that, and then other bands like Faith No More have definitely got a part in there. So there's so many different influences, but it's hard to say where we actually fit in our style, because some of it is quite grungy, some of it is punky, some of it is rock. We don't really think about it, to be honest, when we're playing. We just sort of think, right, what sounds good, what works for us, what are we enjoying, and then from that we just do what we want, really. So that's where that is.
This brings us to my next question. Where did the name come from? Because it's quite an interesting name. It's not one that you would just come up with. It's got to have a story behind it.
Yeah, the name Last Misfit Heroes, that came from when I was thinking about putting the band together. And at that time, January 2019, I had a particularly bad, I was going through a particularly bad time with my own mental health. And so what I wanted to do with the band, I'm sort of using it as a bit of a therapy, if you like, to get my creative side going. But what I wanted was a name that sort of reflected where I was at the time and what this is about, really. So the Misfit Heroes, the idea of that is, not fitting in, feeling like a misfit, but then appreciating that and just doing it, just being yourself and being who you want to be. I think, especially in life, especially the way things are nowadays, everyone is going to be struggling with what's going on. If not directly affecting them, they're going to know people it's going to affect. It's going to change our way of life in a big way. And mental health is a massive thing for myself. But also for the band, just sort of knowing that you're not alone. If you don't feel like you fit in, and you don't really understand what's going on in the world, and you don't, there's a lot of people feel like that, and I think that's where the name comes from, really. We feel like me. Well, I personally feel like the life I was sort of leading before this band, I didn't really I wasn't particularly comfortable with it, and so the idea of being a misfit is how I see myself. But then I'm trying to be look at that in a positive way, if you like, and that's where the heroes part comes in, and it's just appreciating who you are, really. And then from that, moving on from that, it's really, the hero, everyone coming together and working together.
On to the next question. What is the songwriting process like for you as a band?
The songwriting process, right? That's yeah. With Last Misfit Heroes songs, that basically comes. I would come up with an idea with on the guitar, or it'd be melody line. I'd get the inspiration for a song, and I basically have the idea of where I want it to go, and have some sort of idea of arrangements and different parts, and then I take it to the other two, and the three of us then sit down. Work it out, we'd make any changes, and then we turn into a Last Misfit Heroes song. But I mean, I'll make up the original ideas and a lot of the lyrics and things like that, but really the song doesn't become a song until the three of us have had our input in it. So it's a really nice way of doing it, and also it's the way this band works. There's no sort of limit on how we write. Ange may have some ideas for lyrics or a bass line or something like that, and we'd work on it, and it comes together. But it's difficult in some respects because I wouldn't say we have an actual process. I think some songs are different in the way we work. Sorry, some songs are slightly different in how they come together. Some come together very quickly. We've got a track on our EP called When My Empire Falls, and that basically took me, I don't know, 15 minutes to write. And then as soon as I took it to the other two guys, we had the song together within, I'd say, two goes, three goes, and it just stuck, and we didn't have to do a lot with it. So that's one extreme. And then there's another extreme, the actual title track of Misfit Misplaced. That has taken a long, long time to get to where it got to on the EP. It was one of the first tracks I'd sort of had an idea of what I wanted to do with it when we first got the band together. So it's been going around for about a year, and then it never quite got to what I wanted it to, where I wanted to get to. And then when we sat down and talked about what do we want to put on the EP, that was one that I thought, yeah, that would work. So we spent a bit of time on that, and it came together really well for the EP. So, like I was saying, the songwriting process, it depends where we are at the time.
Who are your biggest influences as a band?
Have to say, some of the older musicians like Lemmy, Kurt Cobain, Joe Strummer, The Clash, people like that are a big influence. They've all lived their lives in a certain way. And they've all, and there's good things about that, and there's also bad things about that. And I think it's interesting to see how they sort of saw life and how they reflected on life and how it worked for them in one respect, but then in a lot of other respects it didn't work. So yeah, people like that influence me, and influence the band, and again, that sort of comes back to the whole idea of the Misfit thing.
If you were to create a festival bill, who would be on it?
Fantasy bill, that would I would, as a headliner, I'd have the Foo Fighters. I wouldn't say I was a massive fan of the Foo Fighters, but there's a couple of their albums which are, I think, are brilliant. But seeing them live, they're just something else. They really are something else. And so they would definitely be like on the headlining. Then other bands that, we've seen, me and Andrew seen a few times, like Iron Maiden, their stage show is unbelievable. And it's a fantastic stage show. Queens of Stone Age, they would be on there. So it's all bands like that, really. Alice in Chains, they would be on there. Faith No More. So yeah, some really good bands that we'd chuck on there. And then obviously we'd have to be on there as well. But we wouldn't mind opening for all those bands. That'd be great. So that's good.
That's cool. Okay, for the next question. Name a band or artist that you like, but people will not necessarily associate you with.
For me, again, personally, I would say The Kinks are probably a band that you wouldn't listen to our music and think, there's an influence. But his songwriting, Ray Davies' songwriting, is something else. There's not many people who can do it, but I think when you listen to his lyrics and the whole feel of the song, something like Dead End Street, it just conjures up pictures of like the 60s and it tells you exactly what's going on at the time. And songs like Waterloo Sunset are just incredible. And he's had a real way, and he still has a real way of, expressing and telling a story that really gets to you, and it sort of paints pictures with the music, and it's incredible. So yeah, that's a band that you probably wouldn't think we would listen to.
What made you want to pick up the guitar?
Well, again, going back to what we're saying about with Ange, I grew up with him, and we sort of got into our main about the same time when we were about 11 or 12. And so we sort of watched the videos, and Ange actually bought a guitar before me. And so we got together. I remember us watching Live After Death, sort of Aces High, and all the Iron Maiden songs. I listened to them and thinking, that's what we want to do. And it's gone from there, really. And that was definitely the reason why we picked up a guitar. Also for me, Richie Blackmore from Deep Purple. There's a video that I had of the California Jam, and I don't know how many times I saw it when I was younger, probably about 14, 15, but I used to watch it all the time. And basically, I think they only do about four songs in an hour and a half or something, but the actual ending where Richie Blackmore blows up his stacks and smashes up probably about eight or nine guitars, that's an incredible sight, and well worth watching if you ever want to just sort of see what a rock guitar god should be doing. That's it. That's another reason why I picked it up.
If you could hold a concert or festival, if you could hold a concert or be part of a festival, where would it be, or which festival would you want to be on the bill for?
If we were to hold a concert, I would love to do one probably somewhere in New York. I love New York. Putting on a gig there would be great. There's something about New York which really appeals to me. And having been there, I've only been there once, but yeah, I could definitely spend a day there doing a festival, or just going around the place again. It's an amazing place. So that would be great. If we were to do a festival over here or anywhere else in the world that's going, I would say probably Glastonbury would be great. I think that's probably one of the most recognized festivals around the world, and it'd be great to play that. That would be amazing.
What's the best advice that you have been given?
Best advice I've been given. Best advice I've been given. As I mentioned before, I had a few issues with mental health, and I went to a group thing once, and I didn't really take a lot from it, but I just took one bit of advice that I heard the lady who was running it say. And she said, if the reason why you don't get out of these depressions and things like that, or you don't change, things don't change, is because you're not changing how you're living. And that really struck a bell with me. And so when I've come to put this band together, I've changed my whole thought process about a band. What should a band be? Probably, in years before, when I wanted to sort of make it, whatever that was, when I was younger, I looked at a band as probably, trying to make a way of life of it, or just, I don't know, even really thinking about it. But now with the new band, we've changed our way we think. We're just enjoying the band, and that's enough. You know, that's enough. We're not trying to change the world. It'd be nice if we can get our music heard by as many people as possible. But we, at the end of it, the three of us are getting out of it what we need to get out of it, and if everyone wants to come along with us and enjoy the ride, if you like, then the more the merrier. So that was definitely a good bit of advice, really.
If you could collaborate with any band or artist, who would it be?
People to collaborate with. I would love, right, people who I'd like to collaborate with. I would definitely like to work with Lana Del Rey. Her voice is absolutely fantastic. It probably wouldn't be as heavy as some of the stuff we're doing, but I think between the Lost Misfit Heroes and her voice, the two things would go together amazingly well. So that'd be great.
For the next question, what has been your biggest challenge as a band so far?
So the biggest challenge, I think, is just the way that everything is at the moment musically. We had released our debut EP back in April this year, and we'd had a whole load of gigs lined up to promote it. So that's a big challenge, is to try and promote our material without playing live. Things like this, doing radio stations and getting our songs played as often and everywhere as we can. That's our challenge, really. But we are definitely going to be back once this is all over. So can't wait to do it live. Can't wait to get out and start, sharing these tunes again.
Okay, I think we have time for one more question before our time is up. And that is, what message would you like to give your fans who are listening? Or your new fans that you have gained from today?
Yeah, we'd just like to say we are about to record 6 new songs in August, which we're quite excited about. So there'll be an album's worth of material, and the idea is we're going to release the songs gradually over the next 6 months or so. And for anyone who likes the songs they've heard so far on the EP, of come and see us live, then there's definitely going to be more material coming from us. And and another message is, let's hope we can go out and do some gigs, and we can meet up in the whatever the world is in the next few months or years or whatever it's going to be. But we'll definitely be back.
Thank you, Steve, for being on today's show. I've enjoyed our conversation, and I've found it interesting in what influenced your band. I can definitely hear it, and I hope everyone else can hear it, and I hope everyone goes and checks you out and checks out the band, and I definitely think you'll be one to watch within the future.
Thanks for having me on your show. I've really enjoyed it, and hopefully catch up with you soon.